Well, the NAACP is bringing thousands of visitors and millions of dollars to Kansas City this week.
And one area of the city that has seen its struggles is already cashing in big. Beth Vaughn has our top story.
The American Jazz Museum is in the heart of the district at 18th and Vine, giving national convention goers a chance to soak in some KC sites rich with African American history.
The 101st NAACP National Convention is underway, bringing in folks from across the country.
I said, welcome to Missouri, and I was on the phone with my wife, and she said, I thought you was already in Missouri.
From D.C. to K.C., Keith Scott is soaking it all in.
Some places are good for barbecue, so what is Kansas City good for?
Barbecue, of course, but Barbara Thompson from the American Jazz Museum says there's more to Kansas City than good sauce.
The jazz experience started with African Americans, and that's very significant because it is America's only classic music.
History that promises to draw in thousands of convention goers. Thomas says the museum hasn't crunched numbers yet, but there's a chance to raise big bucks.
Their national office told us that there are 6,000 attendees, and we would be overwhelmed to receive all 6,000, but that's the best possible problem to have.
The Kansas City Blues and Jazz Juke House hopes to cash in too.
As far as the crowd and numbers are concerned, we don't care, we just want the numbers.
Numbers that could help out a district that struggled to stay alive in the past.
Typically, the American Jazz Museum and the Negro Leagues Baseball Museum are closed on Mondays, but because of the convention and the huge demand, Thomas says both museums will keep their doors open to the public. Beth Vaughn, NBC Action News.